1, 2, 3, 4.
So weep not for me, my friend,
when my time below does end. For my life belongs to him who will raise the dead again. And it don't matter where you bury me, I'll be home and I'll be free. It don't matter where I lay, all my tears be washed away. Be long enough for me to feel like I've had long enough with you. Forget the world now, we won't let them see, but there's one thing left to do. Well, now that the weight has lifted, love has surely shifted my way. Marry me today and every day. Marry me if I ever get the nerve to say hello in this cafe. Say you will. Promise me, always be
homicide. I promise to sing you all the music dies. Marry me today and every day. Marry me if I ever get the nerve to say hello in this cafe. Say you will. Say you will. Said with my James, that's a fine motorbike. Girl could feel special on any searchlight. Said James, Red Molly, oh, my hat's off to you. It's a Vincent Black Lightning, 1952. And I've seen you on the corners and cafes, it seems. Red hair and black leather are my favorite color schemes. He pulled her on behind, down the Box Hill. We did right. Said James, Red Molly, here's a ring for your right hand. I tell you in earnest, I'm a dangerous man. We're fine with the law since I was 17. Robbed many a man to get this Vincent machine. Now I'm 21 years, I might make 22. And I don't mind dying, but for the love of you. Should break my stride. I give you my Vincent motorcycle to ride.
James, in my opinion, there's nothing in this world
beats 52 vents and that red-headed girl. Now more tons of minions and gypsies won't do, cause they don't have a soul like a Benson 52. He reached for her hand and he slipped her the keys. Said, I've got no further use for these. I see angels and aerials in leather and chrome, swooping down from heaven to carry me home. Kiss and die, gave her his Vincent to ride. To stand, she told me to sit and wait.
gone. If I were a train, I'd be late. And if I were a good man, I'd talk with you more often than I do. If I were to sleep, I could dream. If I were afraid, I could hide. If I go insane, will you put your wires in my brain? If I were the moon, I'd be cool. If I were a room, I would bend. If I were a good man, I'd understand the spaces between friends. If I were alone, I would cry. If I were you, I'd be hard and dry. If I were a swan, I'd be gone. If I were a train, I'd be late again. If I were a good man, I'd talk to you more often. Thank you.
need you. Yes, I need you every step of the way. Yes, I need you. Oh, I need you every step of the way. And everything I've ever wanted, I've found in you.
Thank you.
Colleen O'Leary. Raise your glass and make a toast, the finest of the scene. A bride and man is sweet bunny lass, it's Patty and Colleen. He gave his harp, he gave a ring, he gave a sign for well. When the captain called him up and told him they would sail. So raise your glass and make a toast, the finest ever seen. A bride and man is sweet bunny lass, it's Patty and Colleen. So he wrote a little song. They said, I will be coming soon, and they're gonna be gone. Raise your glass and make a toast, the finest ever seen. A bride and a man and a sweet bunny lass, it's Patty and Colleen. A storm had brewed a yonder way far from the Emerald Isle. Your Patty and the captain fought to save the ship from trial. So raise your glass and make a toast, the finest ever seen. A bride and lad and a sweet bunny lass, it's Patty and Colleen. But his Irish luck had left him, his ship was seen no more. Song is still rolling along on the waves to Colleen on the shore. So raise your glass and make a toast to the finest ever seen. A bright young lad and his sweet bonny lass, it's Patty and Colleen.
Fragrant meadows of dawn.
there was love all around, but I never heard it sing. No, I never heard it all till there was you.
Started making money way up in the tree.
Cut down the trees and the honey's all gone. Snoopfoot is done, made himself at home. He's big around the middle and he's broad across the room. Running 90 miles an hour, taking 30 feet a jump. Ain't never been caught, he ain't never been a tree. Some folks say he looks a lot like me. River's froze over, so where can he go? I chase him up the gully and I run him in the well. Shoot him in the bottom just to listen to him yell. He's big around the middle and he's broad across the room. Running 90 miles an hour, taking 30 feet jump. Ain't never been caught, he ain't never been a tree. Some folks say he looks a lot like me. Some folks say he looks a lot like me. Some folks say he looks a lot like me. sorrow, and I see trouble on my lane. Kentucky, the state where I was born and raised. The state where I was born and raised. For 6 long years, I've been in trouble. No pleasure here on earth I found. For in this world I'm bound to ramble, got no friend to help me now. I got no friend to help me now. Thank you.
I've seen trouble all my days.
I bet I'm the only person I know. I bet I'm the only person you know that has an Uncle Puss. His name was really Buford, but he was my granddad's brother, Uncle Puss. And he was, unlike the rest of us McCaslands, he was short and pot-bellied and kind of balding in front. So anyway, it was old Uncle Puss, and he lived right down the corner, right down the street and around the corner from Granddad. And so every Christmas we go up to Mesa to have our Christmas with Meemaw and Granddad and Uncle Puss and Aunt Sis and my cousins and Uncle Lloyd and Aunt Linda and them, and we'd have Christmas. And they're all farmers. All the men were farmers. My dad was a farmer. He was a cotton ginner at the time, as I was a little older, but earlier he was a farmer, cotton farmer, and Dad and Granddad and Uncle Puss and everybody, they're all farmers too. So on Christmas, the men wouldn't get to the Christmas thing until they had done their work. And so they'd come in early. They'd come in about 4 or 5 in the afternoon to have Christmas, while the rest of us kids, this is in the late 50s and early 60s, and the women were in the house doing what kids and women do around Christmas time up there in La Mesa, which is, you know, just eat, and go out and play in the yard there, the dirt yard in front of the farmhouse. Oh, Uncle Puss, we'd see his old pickup driving down the road, and all the kids would gather around the sofa right there in Meemaw's room, and we just get on the floor in a circle and wait for Uncle Puss, and he would come in, and he'd be looking at us, and he always had an old cigar that he chewed on, or he smoked down until he couldn't get his hand around it anymore. Then he'd put that little stub of a cigar in his pipe and tamp that down and light that and smoke the rest of that cigar, because I imagine he smoked one cigar a day. And that was, you know, so it was about 5 in the afternoon, and he'd come in, and he'd say, "What are you kids looking at?" "You know what, Uncle Puss, you know what, Uncle Puss?" And he'd sit down, and he'd light that pipe, and we'd all wait and wait, and the excitement would get more and more unbearable. Back in the 1920s, Uncle Puss had lost his right leg in a bull riding episode. A bull had fallen over and with him on it, and it smushed his leg, and he had to have his leg amputated. So he, you know, we were all sitting around watching the sofa, watching Uncle Puss, and finally, after staring at all of us kids and winking at all the grown-ups, he had reached down and rolled his britches leg up on his right leg, and there's his old wooden leg thing. He did unsnap it and pull it off upside down. There's all the Christmas candy, and all the candy would come out of Uncle Puss's right leg just like a pinata. And we all gather around the floor and dive on that candy. It was always the high point of our Christmas. And so ever since then, every time I've seen a one-legged or one-armed person, I've always wanted to go up and see what's inside their prosthesis. I always look at that type of thing with great glee and great pleasure. And it was all thanks to old Uncle Puss way back yonder. Here you go.